So the question is, could we be getting Sega Dreamcast games to the Nintendo? Seems like it's a very strong possibility. Sounds to me like Sega's working on these things. They're basically throwing out polls to see what gamers would want, what games they would want. They showed off a demo at TGS of virtual racing. This is pretty exciting news. I'm not the biggest Sega fan, and I'll be the first to admit that. But there's a lot of people who I value their opinion on games who have all said that the Dreamcast was probably one of the most amazing consoles of our time. Basically, it died very quickly. Sony and Nintendo just ate it up, and Sega was on the heels of just bad console launch after bad console launch after, you know, the 32X and the Sega CD and the Sega Saturn. So when it basically came to the Dreamcast, it was rushed out. Had tech-wise, it was way ahead of itself in terms of the things it could do. So that being said, I would be definitely interested in trying out some games that basically hit the Dreamcast and a lot of people thought were locked on that console forever and would never come back again. There's a lot of people that love the Dreamcast, a lot of my friends, a lot of the gaming community, so I would love to just get my hands on some of these games and give them a shot. The game library is not vast. It's a smaller game library because the console didn't last that long. It's pretty cool. I'm not going to lie. Like, as a gaming fan, I think this is a pretty spectacular thing to be happening. The Dreamcast was definitely known as a trendsetter of sorts, and I'm pretty interested, not going to lie. So we'll see what happens there. So this box arrived today. I know what's inside of it, but I wanted to finish up today's video and I wanted to discuss some things while I went through this box and opened it up and showed some stuff that's in it. Tonight was a little bit delayed for me. I didn't get home until a little bit later. I was playing Pokemon Go. So what happened was I was heading home from work, and as I was heading home, I hit the typical gym that I always hit, the water tower. It's on my way home. I went there, and as I was there, a couple of friends of mine, Bryce and Nancy, they rolled up next to me, and they were like, "Hey man, you want to take down this gym?" And I was like, "Okay, let's do this." So we took down the gym, and then Nancy tells me about the new Giratina, the new raid that was going to happen in the month of October, were for Halloween kind of type thing, was kicking off today, and actually that the group, the Violent Raiders, had a plan to hit this at 5:45. So I was like, I'm down, I'll be there. On the way over, I called my buddy Miguel, and I'm like, "Miguel, this is what's going down. Meet me here, and let's do this." So I started to drive around a little bit, hit some poke stops, get some balls, get some other things. And then at 5:45, I went over, and man, there was like 20 deep there. And I was like, this is madness. Like, this is crazy that all these people are here. So I was excited, and I was like, okay, this is cool. We go in, and I catch the first one that I go after. Pretty high CP, I think it was 2477, although he was an extra small. I don't know the levels of him yet, because I haven't checked them yet. But that said, so then from there, they're like, "Hey, we're gonna go to the law office after this." So a bunch of people, again, just move from the church we're at right to the law office. We go in. Alex, he introduced himself over at the church. Good guy, man. I'm so glad to have met him, and we exchanged friend codes and all that stuff. So Nancy, Bryce, then I met a couple other guys over at the law office, Chris. And we all just sat and we played, and then we do another raid, and I get my second one. And this one was, I believe, like at 1877 or something like that. I forget the exact numbers on them because I'm talking and the phone's over there, but regardless. So then they're like, "Hey, let's go to the cemetery." And I'm like, "Oh my God, this is nuts." And I'm looking at the clock and I'm like,
I gotta get home, man. I gotta finish my vlogging for the day and all that, but whatever, it doesn't matter. So then we roll on. Good day. It was a good day for collecting or catching Pokemon on Pokemon Go. I got a bunch of stuff in here. So this is another box that I have. A box that was in the box. This thing is really cool. I was really excited to see this, to get this. Let's see what we got here. So, I bought a disc. I'm sorry for the camera. This is, okay. So I bought this disc here. It's actually bigger than I thought it was. My God. So, in theory, what I would do is I would put stuff on this. This is insane, man. So it comes with the power cord. Let's just check this out. I like it. So in theory, this is gonna be good for unboxings in the future, where I can put stuff on the turntable, turn it on, and be able to get full 360 degrees on a lot of this stuff. I'm happy about this. I like this a lot. So this is gonna be cool moving forward. I wish there was different speeds. It just seems like it's this one slow speed. Next thing I bought was this tripod, but it's a multifaceted thing. It is a tripod. It's a selfie stick. It also has a remote control here, which if I sync it to my phone, right? Remote control. Now I can turn it on from a distance and be like, okay, now I need to start recording and go. Because I'm doing this the way I'm doing this lately, right? It was supposed to come with an adapter. Why is there no adapter on this? We can figure this out. Was this with the adapter? This isn't the one I bought. This ain't gonna work. So this was supposed to be a microphone. And it is a microphone. And it was supposed to be for the iPhone. But because iPhone changed the way their stuff is, this won't work. So I guess this little dongle was supposed to be what it is, but I'm supposed to have an adapter to send it from a 3.5 millimeter jack into the lightning switch. Didn't work that way. So now I'm a little SOL, but whatever. I got a microphone for it. I gotta just buy an adapter now. We'll be good to go for that. The Violent Raiders, man, such a great group. They've been really helpful to what I'm doing and learning more about Pokemon Go. Like, I just keep track of the comments that are being said in the chat, and it helps me a lot to see what's going on. And also, like, they're just very inviting. Like, today, Bryce and Nancy, they were just like, hey, let's go over to this raid. You know, come on over. And I was like, I'm thinking in my mind, like, it's just them. But apparently, I didn't get a chance to check the app. They were all talking during the day that, like, we're going to do this, and this is the time we're going to do it. So I appreciate that. That is really awesome of those people. Such a good group. Cannot wait to continue raiding with you guys and continuing this on as we go. So that is all. Thank you guys for watching today's vlog. I hope you enjoyed it, Nintendo Guru Daily. If you did, slap the like button down below. Share it with your friends. If you're not a subscriber, please subscribe. That would be amazing. Follow me Instagram, Twitter, at Nintendo Gurus. That is all. Peace out, Preston. I can't. Too far away. I can't do it today.